beautiful spring-like day here, however, as we're still in the 60s and turning to your Pinpoint Weather 12 forecast.
Chief Meteorologist Tony Petracca is in the Weather Center. And Tony, this unfortunately is not going to last.
Yeah, just that much advertised one-day warm-up, Brian and Kim. But nice while it lasted, briefly 65 to 70 this afternoon. Of course, we're losing the sun now, looking at a pretty sunset. Let me show you a couple of pictures from the western horizon. Which includes Newport, for starters, a few clouds off in the distance. In fact, this is where our next weather system is coming from the west. It's still back through upstate New York. It's a strong cold front. And what it will do is bring some rain here tonight and then back to reality with cooler, colder temperatures by Friday. But the high temps today reaching the upper 60s to around 70 inland and low to mid 60s. Along the coastline. Temperatures have already started to settle back down, especially along the coastline, where while it's still mild for this time of year, it has dropped off into the upper 50s. Average high for this time of year, 53, and of course, way above that today. And then the noticeable cool down both Friday and Saturday. Brief spike in the temperature Sunday, Monday, and another free fall Tuesday and Wednesday of next week. So a lot of ups and downs, variability with the temperature next 5 to 7 days. But threat tracker now through Friday in the weekend overall is low. But just keep in mind that if you have travel plans, say midnight and beyond, roads will be wet. We do expect some rain, but it's gone by daybreak Friday. Gusty breeze, colder, drier skies with partly sunny conditions. Just have to, you know, break out the warm coats once again. The leading edge of the rain is still just west of Albany, New York. This is along that strong cold front. So it's this blue line right in here. So this will track off to the east overnight. As it swings offshore by tomorrow morning, it brings in cooler air. So out ahead of the front, these gusty southerly breezes really bumping up the temperature. Opposite wind direction behind the cold front, west and northwest, bringing in that noticeable chill by daybreak. You can clearly see behind the cold front all this blue representing the colder air that's on the way. This little sliver of orange up and down the east coast is our spring-like weather, which is coming to an end. All right, we'll step you through it hour by hour. This evening, we're dry through at least, say, 10 o'clock. Here we are, midnight. The leading edge of the precipitation is starting to work in. It's still in the 50s, so mild. Rain likely overnight. Here's the back edge of the precipitation around, say, 5, 6 in the morning. We push that offshore. It's a blustery, gusty, but drier day, and then notice it'll be cooler. We go from almost 70 this afternoon to mid and upper 40s tomorrow afternoon. And then your Friday night's fine, but it's clear, and it's a lot colder. We're back down to freezing. So out the door, it's not springtime. It's back to fall. Temperature's chilly, but developing sunshine. The breeze making it feel a little colder. And then here we are during the afternoon. The best we can do is probably mid to upper 40s. All right, 7-day forecast shows less wind, sunshine, chilly on Saturday. Extra clouds on Sunday. We're going to keep the daylight hours of Sunday dry. We'll bring in some of these showers on Sunday evening and Sunday night. I would say by sunset Sunday, the rain works in. That sets up for unsettled weather, Kim, Monday and Tuesday with showers and temperatures of 40s and 50s. Not bad this evening, but some rain later tonight.
And most of the weekend looks okay?
I would say 2/3 of it. Towards the tail end of Sunday, watch for some rain.
Okay. All right. Yep. Tony, thanks. Brian?